tonight about what the Clinton campaign thinks went so wrong versus what they expected, Jackie. But obviously, she was out with Bill in the woods taking a walk today, and she posed for that picture. So
life goes on. It has to, right? Mm-hmm. And you know, the fact that they're out hiking in the woods. But I think, you know, to that woman's point, seeing a lot of Hillary Clinton supporters in my Facebook feed and on Twitter, I think a lot of women especially just wanted to give her a hug. So hearing that, I think she really...
that this woman did that.
That she did that. I think she spoke for a lot of folks out there who are upset.
And there are. There are tens of millions of them, right? I mean, when you look at the vote here, that's how this country split.
And it would have been if Donald Trump
half
lost.
Half the country may be euphoric, and half the country is heartbroken, and it would have been the other way around as well. Basil, the New York Times is reporting, though, that Hillary Clinton privately is admitting she stepped in it. When she did something that Mitt Romney got slammed for, and we know it hurt, and when he said 47%, she said deplorables. Let me just play exactly what she said.
To just be grossly generalistic, you could put half of Trump's supporters into what I call the basket of deplorables. Right? The racist, sexist, homophobic, xenophobic, Islamophobic, you name it. And unfortunately, there are people like that.
Did she make a big mistake? Was that something that a lot of people heard? Pollsters didn't pick it up, and that over the summer could have started to turn that Rust Belt away from her?
Yeah, I don't know if that's the issue. I do think she believes it was a mistake because she said so right afterwards. So, but I actually don't think that in and of itself was the issue. I do believe that the way she characterized some of Donald Trump's comments, I think those are things that over the course of time we've seen, and you know, I've remarked about it, others have remarked about it. But I think she was particularly contrite about that and sort of admitted that right off the bat. I think the emails themselves and the consistent stories about those emails, I think, fed into a narrative about her that was difficult to overcome. But I don't think it was that common itself.
What do you think? Do you think that this actually influenced people who were independent and persuadable?
I think it did. And I want to, in a partial sense, defend Hillary Clinton here. I think she really believes that. But she is not alone. If you notice the response...
Really believes the basket of deplorables.
Right, and the string of things she added. I went back and took a look at her famous speech at Wellesley when she was graduating, and it had the same theme. One of the reasons I became a Reaganite conservative instead of I was once upon a time a wannabe liberal when I was in college, is that I began to pick up this contempt for, like, American working people and the American middle class, contempt for their values and all of this sort of thing, which I think American liberalism has come to exemplify. And that little statement from her is a snapshot. I'm totally convinced that she really believes it, and more to the point, the people that were in the room laughing agreed.
I think you take it a little too far, though, because to A, say that liberals have this contempt for the working class when so many of us are, and to be able to say that she herself has that kind of contempt, I think is stretching that comment to a point it shouldn't go to.
I don't think it should go to. Talk about the candidate, don't talk about their voters.
That's right.
But I mean, Jeffrey's also made a good point consistently for weeks now, which is this contrast between the elites that Hillary Clinton represented and Donald Trump, despite where he lives and all of his money, what he represented to folks. And I think that does reinforce it. But I also agree that I don't think it made a huge difference in terms of the campaign.
Well, I'm going to leave it there. Okay. Thank you. And next, the GOP threatening to rip Obama's signature issue.